Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's my privilege and pleasure to invite all of you. In albeit difficult times, we are not yet free from the dangerous scourge that has taken the entire world under its power. But since we believe that music heals, and I think we are in a position better than what we were a year ago to fight the disease, we are vaccinating ourselves in large numbers, did we decide that we will organize the first ever Sarod Festival here in Kolkata, a physical concert after a very, very long time. Brought to you by none other than the Annapurna Devi Foundation and in association with Shyam Sundar Jewelers. By many an account, she was an artist who may have been the best Indian classical musician of the 20th century. And this is not an exaggeration. But this superlative talent chose to erase herself from public life many, many years ago. In fact, she played only a couple of times till she was 30, and then she shut herself off from public life. Before, Annapurna Devi had earned her way into the musical stratosphere. As a young girl, the young Roshanara Khan, she was not allowed to study music, unlike her illustrious brother, Swar Samrat, Sarod Samrat, Ustad Ali Akbar Khan Sahab. Their father, the great seer, Baba Ustad Alauddin Khan Sahab, didn't want to teach music to his daughter. But she was always listening to her older brother learning the sarod. When she was about 10, she heard her brother making a minor mistake while he was having his talim and corrected him. Her father overheard and changed his mind. He began her on the sitar, but later asked her to take on the surbahar, telling her that her refinement and musical depth will be appreciated by connoisseurs. The choice, he said, was hers. True to her father's words, she took on the surbahar and transported it into a connoisseur's delight. The legendary recluse she was, she passed on her knowledge and discipline to shape generations of classical music maestros, names, milestones like Pandit Nikhil Banerjee, Ustad Bahadur Khan Sahab, Ustad Ashish Khan, her nephew, Pandit Hari Prasad Chaurasia, Pandit Nityanand Haldipur, to name just a few. Friends, living in an era in which artists are judged or even defined by popularity, this rishi of classical music never allowed concerns of popular acceptance intrude into the private realm of her musical journey or musicality. On the contrary, she imagined that the objects of her musical pursuit in terms entirely removed from performance. Her life, her approach to music, can only be compared to that of the yogis meditating in icy caves on the heights of the Himalayas. Supposing that such a personality were to send to live in a city, that is the kind of life she lived. She had a total lack of desire for worldly benefit. She was in no hurry to mold a large number of stalwart musicians, content to wait till her disciple was ready to go on the next stage. Yet, as I said, she was a guru to some of the greatest names. The Indian government granted her many an award, the Padma Bhushan, the Sangeet Natak Academy. But those awards came decades after she retreated from the world. She never made a professional recording. The only recordings that exist of her playing were made surreptitiously, and naturally were not of a good quality. You would be surprised that even the Padma Bhushan had to be delivered to her home. She did not attend the ceremony at Rashtrapati Bhavan. She has always remained outside the glare of arc lights. We are fortunate here in Kolkata to celebrate her music, her life, by way of dedicating this Sarod festival, this three-day festival, with six leading Sarodiyas. This is a fortune for us, and what a way to tell you that music is a healer than through the Sarod festival in her memory in these difficult times. Friends, with these few words, may I request the founder and the managing trustee of the Annapurna Devi Foundation, her disciple, Pandit Nityanand Haldipur, India's leading flautist, to come and welcome all of you. But prior to that, I think what we will do is, we will garland the two portraits here. We have with us two portraits, as you see. On my right, you have the legendary Ustad Baba Alauddin Khan, and on the left, we have Ma Annapurna Devi. So the father-daughter duo's portrait will be garlanded by the musicians present today. We will begin with Pandit Tejendra Narayan Mazumdar and Pandit Basant Kabra garlanding the portrait of Ma Annapurna Devi, please. Pandit Tejendra Narayan Mazumdar, would you step in front, please? There he is. And Pandit Basant Kabra garlanding the photo of Ma Annapurna Devi. Sarod Festival gets underway. Brought to you by the Annapurna Devi Foundation in association with Shyam Sundar Jewelers. So let us applaud. This is a very happy occasion. A physical concert after a long, long time. I've always thought that no performing art is possible online. So, now, with Ma Annapurna Devi's garlanding over, may I request the artist today, young Shiraz Ali Khan, her grand nephew, and Pandit Bikram Ghosh, who will come on stage in a little while to come and garland the portrait of Ustad Baba Alauddin Khan Sahab. Young Shiraz paying obeisance at the photo of his great-grandfather, the illustrious Ustad Baba Alauddin Khan. Beautiful. Pandit Bikram Ghosh. One of India's best known and best loved percussion ambassadors that the world has today, Pandit Bikram Ghosh. May I request Pandit Nityanand Haldipur to come here as the managing trustee and say a few words and welcome all of you, please.
नमस्कार. आप सब लोगों को देख के मुझे बहुत खुशी हो रही है और मैं ये सोच सकता हूँ कि कलकत्ता क्यों इतना भारत का कल्चरल सेंटर बना हुआ है. आप लोगों का जो प्यार है संगीत के लिए ये दिखाई दे रहा है. आप सभी लोगों को आने के लिए मैं आपका स्वागत करता हूँ. ये सरोज सम्मेलन जो हम लोग कर रहे हैं अन्नपूर्णा देवी फाउंडेशन के तरफ से, ये मेरे ख्याल से कलकत्ता में फर्स्ट टाइम हो रहा है और मेरे ख्याल से काफ़ी देर के बाद हिंदुस्तान में ये सेकंड सरोज सम्मेलन हो सकता है. ये सरोज सम्मेलन के लिए हम लोगों को बहुत कलाकारों का सहयोग मिला और इसका सिलेक्शन जो हम लोग मतलब सिलेक्शन नहीं कह सकते हैं कि मतलब हम लोगों ने आर्टिस्ट को जो इनवाइट किया उसके पीछे हम लोगों की ये भावना थी कि जो श्रेष्ठ गुरु हो गए सरोद या सितार या सब इसमें और उन्होंने जो अच्छे शिष्य तैयार किए उनको ये सम्मेलन में शामिल करना था. जैसे कि उस्ताद आशीष खां साहब, फिर उस्ताद पंडित रविशंकर जी, पंडित बुद्धदेव दास गुप्ता जी, मेरे गुरु माँ अन्नपूर्णा देवी, बहादुर खां साहब, उस्ताद बहादुर खां साहब और उस्ताद अमजद अली खां साहब और राधिका बाबू, ये जो श्रेष्ठ गुरु है जिन्होंने अपने शागिर्द तैयार किए इन लोगों को सबनों हमने एक न्योता दिया कि आप इस सम्मेलन में शागिर्द हो शामिल हो. और बड़ी खुशी की बात है कि ये सभी कलाकारों ने इतना हम लोगों को सहयोग दिया है कि सभी नामी कलाकार हैं इंटरनेशनली लेकिन किसी ने अपनी प्रोफेशनल फीस हमसे मांगी नहीं. एक गुरु माँ के रिस्पेक्ट के लिए इन्होंने जो भी है इस मतलब स्वीकार करके आज ये कार्यक्रम में शामिल हुए हैं. स्पेशली मुझे दो नाम यहाँ मेंशन करने जैसे लगते हैं कि जिन्होंने कुछ भी लिए बगैर रेम्यूनरेशन फ्री में कार्यक्रम में सहभाग किया है वो है अभी जो तबला संगत करेंगे पंडित विक्रम घोष जी और जो अभी आपने देख नामचीन कलाकार जो है तेजेंद्र नारायण जी सरोद के. ये इनके वजह से ये सरोद का सम्मेलन सक्सेसफुल हो रहा है. और हम लोग जब सरोद का नाम हम लोग सरोद जब बोलते हैं तो हमारे सामने एक नाम प्रखर से दिखाई देता है वो है सुर सम्राट उस्ताद अली अकबर खां साहब का. अभी ये साल 13 तारीख से उनका सेंटेनरी ईयर शुरू हो रहा है तो इसलिए ये भी एक वजह थी कि हम ये सरोद सम्मेलन शुरू करें तो उनके सेंटेनरी ईयर से ही शुरू करें. आज हम लोग एक लाइव परफॉर्मेंस मिस कर रहे हैं वो है गुरु सम्मान अवार्ड जिनको दिया गया. हम अन्नपूर्णा देवी फाउंडेशन के तरफ से दो अवार्ड देते हैं, एक मेल गुरु को पुरुष जो है गुरु और दूसरे फीमेल मतलब स्त्री गुरु जिन्होंने का बहुत योगदान है संगीत क्षेत्र में. वैसे एक बहुत ही श्रेष्ठ कलाकार विद्वान जो उनके जवानी में तरफ मतलब बहुत ही फैंटास्टिक परफॉर्मर रहे और गुरु तो बहुत ही मतलब उच्च दर्जा के गुरुओं की जिनके शागिर्द पूरी दुनिया में फैले हुए हैं ऐसे एक पंडित विद्वान श्यामल कुमार चट्टोपाध्याय, उनकी तबीयत के वजह से वो आज नहीं आ सकते हैं, लेकिन कल हमने जाके उनके घर में उनको सम्मान दिया, साइटेशन, और उनका सम्मान किया। और ये भी हमें खुशी है कि ये सम्मान उन्होंने स्वीकार किया, हम लोगों के लिए बहुत बड़ी बात है ये कि ऐसे गुरु हमारे गुरु को भी रिस्पेक्ट करते हैं उनके नाम से। तो इतना ही कहना है आपके बीच में और कलाकारों के बीच में मैं आना नहीं चाहता हूँ, तो आपके लिए मैं धन्यवाद वापस एक बार बोल दें।
Thank you, Pandit Nityanand Haldipurji. You've just heard that yesterday, because of his frail health, we couldn't have Pandit Shyamal Kumar Chattopadhyay here, one of India's doyens of the Sitar, disciple of the great Ustad Dabir Khan Saab, and later, of course, the great Guru Pandit Ravi Shankar as well. We have a brief recording of the of when we went to hand over the samman to him, and this snippet will be shown right in front of you. Can we have the screening, please?
I am grateful to Baba Alauddin and Annapurna Devi, who I used to call Annapurna D, for honoring me in this fabulous way. Really, my heartfelt gratitude to them and my endless pranam to them. At least in my this age of 93 years of age, I am sick with my leg and COPD, waist and all. You know, at this age people suffer from various diseases, and as such, I personally cannot go to the concert at Giri Villa Sabhaghar, which they are holding for 3 days, 2nd, 3rd, and 4th. I wish and pray to God that this concert should come out very, very successfully, touching the mind of everybody and remembering Baba Alauddin and Annapurna Devi. In my life, from 1953, I have started playing from the radio, All India Radio, Calcutta. And in my old days, those times, 50s, 60s, 70s, there are so many classical music conferences which cannot be seen now excepting Doval. All India Sadarak Music Conference, All India Tanshan Music Conference, All India Music Conference, Bach Circus Music Conference, Central Calcutta Music Conference, North Calcutta Music Conference, Baliganj Music Conference, Srirampur Music Conference, And Uttabara Swami Chakra, of course, Uttabara Swami Chakra is still going on. And Baligan Musical Palace, that is now Doverland Musical Palace. So I played in all those places. Being a non-professional person. And my principle was, as instructed by Wi-Fi first guru, the last Jainyana Mia Tanshe, Mia Devi Khasai. And after his demise as 71, Pandit Ravi Shankar. They told me always, look, don't go on to the same line or similar line as other artists going. You must have to make a separate chapter for it. And that is only if you play Ankavan Tal and Ankavan Ragas, which will be a different position for you and make you an artist of different status from the stereotype instrument players of India. And all through my life I have been doing that, and I also taught all my students who are all over the world. They are all my students, everybody in the world. There you get one of my students who is brilliant over there. So these are not my credit. I only did. But how I could be successful in this, that is the blessings of my gurus and nothing else. Unless sometimes when playing on the stage, I was allotted 1.5 hours or 2 hours, but I played 5-6 hours. Unwillingly, I continued like that. 6 hours at a stretch I played on the stage, and people were spellbound to hear me. These are what? Sometimes it happens while playing that Guru himself sits on the head and makes me play, makes the artist play. Until the Guru sits on the head and makes the artist play, it is not possible to play in such a way. Means what? Means all Guru's blessings, which is mostly lacking nowadays. All gurus are bought by money. I call them teachers, like school, college teachers. They take money, they give money, and they learn in the book. Write some notations and give them to practice. But my talim is not that way. Not a single tan, not a single bowl, nothing was written in my khata, only ragas. And how to play, which way to play, and which side to play, which not to touch, was taught to me by both Devi Khan Sahib and Pandit Ravi Shankar on voice. On voice, sitar was in my hand. And they used to give talim in voice. Because the instrument is played by fingers. Everybody's fingers are not the same. Main thing is to bring out the real sound out of it, which is the output of the player. And that he can bring by any finger. There are left-handers also. Both tabla, setar, sarodara. Baba himself was left-hander. So are you going to say that he was not an artist? These are all fake talks and useless talks. Main thing is to improvise the raga properly and take the taal, such as people will have to count in the auditorium to see how the artist is going on the taala laya and the eye. That much I can tell you, being the senior most artist in India now, 93 years of age, this will, I believe this will help the learners and the gurus both to follow this line. Thank you very much.